The stormy weather that battered the East Coast is now having a deadly impact on the region's marine life. And a warning tonight to steer clear of kaimoana that's washed up on beaches after thousands of dead crayfish and paua were found among debris along the shore. Efforts continue to deliver supplies to cut off communities north of Gisborne. And the main highway is now open, but just during daylight hours. Corazon Miller has developments.
One there, look, more here.
Kaimoana. Precious gifts from Tangaroa.
Even big ones, look.
This vital source of food left rotting.
We have nothing left. Well, kids, oh, look.
That's only the tip of the iceberg, really, because there's thousands of paua and kina underneath all that slash.
For this time of year, which we're normally obviously very much orientated towards the sea being a provider for us, you know, in terms of fishing and equally for kaimoana.
In the aftermath of Cyclone Hale, masses of dead shellfish have washed up on the shores of Ruatoria.
What a waste.
For me, it was heartbreaking to see all that. We can't do anything. We've all just got to let it, you know, let it go through the stages of rotting and going back out the tongue at all.
Officials warn against salvaging what's washed up.
Marine life in these situations can be dangerous to human health due to potential pollutants that may be present.
It's the storm that's brought it all to the shore, but locals say deforestation's also to blame.
It's caused all the erosion and sends all the salt and sediment down the rivers and out to Tongaroa.
These rural communities along New Zealand's most eastern coastlines have been cut off for days. The main highways reopened today, but will close again overnight. Power and cell phone coverage is mostly back on.
Certainly got some households that remain not yet connected back onto the power grid.
While the cleanup's on track, it won't be the last for our coastal communities.
Severe weather events will become a feature of our future, and we all need to recognise that and plan for that. And if we do, if we get behind the idea of becoming more resilient, then that these communities will continue to be viable.
That help can't come soon enough.
These generations of kaimoana that's been, that our tipu looked after, and now we're kind of losing their battles. So how do I explain to my kids and my grandkids that we tried as much as we could.
This dad ever fearful of the day the sea will have nothing left to give. Corazon Miller, One News.